It is not the same as Vanderpump Rules. She says, none of them have a history, which isn't true. Then she says, okay, well, they kind of have a history. Some of them, like, used to be exes and everything. She also says that it's different because they all live together. So that is different than Vanderpump Rules. Sure. And she says that there are guests that show up. So this is kind of like Vanderpump Rules meets Below Deck. Oh, speaking of Below Deck, did y'all see Miss Zarin, my girl Jill Zarin, on Below Deck? I knew Jill was on Below Deck way when she filmed it. She's like, don't fucking tell anyone. I'm like, I won't, blah, blah, blah. That's neither here nor there. Here we are. She comes on, and now she's getting slammed as one of the most difficult guests ever. I don't know, Jill. Are you playing this up? Did you play it up for the cameras? We all know about Jill's Diet Coke obsession. She wants to... By the way, Jill, I'm gonna fight you on this. I love Diet Coke. I like Diet Pepsi better. Controversial, unpopular opinion. I had to put a lime in my Diet Pepsi. But there you go. So she's like getting slammed as a high-end, how, you know, charter guest, and she's disgusted that there's no toothbrush and toiletries in the bathroom. So if you don't watch Below Deck, watch this episode. I imagine this was a highly rated episode, but my girl, my neighbor in Sag Harbor over there is getting slammed. Oh, Jill, Jill, Jill. I still love you, Jill. I love my Jill. So there you go. But that's what Lisa, so it's kind of like Vanderpump Rules meets Below Deck. Are we gonna watch Vanderpump Villa? Slip into the comments. I don't know. Guys, do I have to watch this? I'm sorry. I don't know. Do we watch? This will be the breakout hit. I'm gonna pass on this. Lisa Vanderpump said that, oh, there's Kyle stuff too. Kyle was asked recently if she heard from Lisa ever about the whole Mauricio thing. She said no, not really a shock. And by the way, Lisa coming back to Beverly Hills, oh my God, that article, which was April Fool's, was so interesting. It said that her and Kyle will always be fine. This is when I should have known it was a like, and blah blah blah, and this and that. But she's really worried about Dorit. Could you imagine a season of? I mean, should we just start doing fan fiction here on Patreon? You know, could you imagine a season of like Vanderpump coming back and being like, okay, Kyle, like, you know, we have our issues, but like, whatever. And both of them just fucking being against Dorit. I mean, Dorit would not be able to handle, I mean, Dorit cannot take on LVP and Kyle. She would crumble in the corner. Maybe not. I mean, the best thing that ever happened to Doreen in her reality TV history, but let's see. Let's see about that. Yeah, so LVP, she's not coming back. She hasn't reached out to Kyle. Kyle said that her and Mo are taking a break from therapy. You want to know what's really strange? Every day I find there's someone new that lives in my building here in LA. So I found out that Rome Flynn, anyone watch How to Get Away with Murder or Station 19? He's from Shondaland. He lives in my building. But that's not the point I'm trying to make. Somebody from sit down, everyone. Somebody from Buying Beverly Hills lives in my building who I was told they're like, you know this guy. He actually lives on my fucking floor, literally on my goddamn floor. Can you imagine this? I think his name is Kevin. He dated someone last year and then they broke up, but he's on this season as well. I'm trying to find his name, but he's on Buying Beverly Hills. And I was talking to him the other day in the workspace where I work, and he was like, going on and on and on about how much he loves Mauricio. This is all off the record. You know, he just loves Mauricio. And like when Mauricio walks into a room, he lights it up. And, you know, they just had their agency summit where everyone from the agency all over the world came. And I really wish I could find this person's name. See, it ties in when I tell you, here it is. When I tell you I'm bad with names, Kevin Stewart lives in my building here. Lovely, lovely guy. He is not like a major player on the agent on the Buying Beverly Hills, but he apparently filmed like four scenes, and all four scenes were kept. I was like, so is everyone at the agency like this guy really actually just wants to do his job? He's not, but like I was like, is everyone at the agency like jockeying for like to be on the show? He's like, oh, please, everybody wants to be on the show. We interviewed two people last season, by the way, Allie Lutz and her colleague. So go listen to that. But someone from Buying Beverly Hills lives on my floor. Who knew? Should we have him on the podcast? I don't know, you guys. There's only so much time in the day. And where is Atlanta? When are we going to get Atlanta? Come on. This is really a long pause. I mean, here's what I don't understand. How long does it take to work it out? I mean, you know you have Portia and you know you have Kenya. There you go. So, I mean, you got to make other casting decisions. Is that hard to find people? Mind you, I appreciate taking a beat and trying to figure this out. Man, that Potomac is going to be a long beat, guys. I'm telling you. I don't think Karen's DUI. Mind you, Karen Huger is acting like the whole thing never happened. She's posting 24/7 as if it never fucking happened. That's all I'm saying. Okay. F and Y and I. I don't know what my point was. So Kyle is taking a break from Mauricio. I mean, shocker. You guys okay that we didn't talk about Jersey? Lots of you are happy when we don't talk about Jersey here. There you go. An extra day with just David. Do you want you could tell on. Here's the problem. I love Rachel. I love Andrea Lopez. And do you want Andrea Lopez? If Andrea Lopez comes on to help us recap Jersey, she's gonna have to like be Teresa, because she can do the Teresa, and she can do that. And then maybe we can interview her as Teresa, like based on the things that happen on the show. I think that could be really funny. Like, here's Andrea, who, no offense to her, doesn't know the show as well as I do or any of you. We can interview her as Teresa and she can give answers. And I can say, but Teresa, I got to hold your feet to the fire. That could be kind of funny. Do you guys want that? Just an idea I had the other day. God, I'm really sharing everything with you guys today. But, Nicole Richie and Joel Madden's kids make their red carpet debut at the premiere of her film. I'm just reading this. This just popped up. God, I mean, are we old, by the way? Are we actually old? Because these are Nicole Richie's children. God, they look so old. How the fuck? First of all, this girl looks exactly like Nicole Richie. How the hell did this fucking happen? Okay, I'm like, really? You see, do I have AD? Do I have ADD here? But Nicole Richie, man, she's hot. Do we want Andrea? Maybe we'll bring her during Jersey. I don't think we need to talk about Jersey until the new season starts, right? I do have a lot of interviews coming from Jersey people. Thank you guys for being here on a Saturday. I love you all. We have some other guests coming here during Jersey only. We have Patreon only. And we'll be recapping it. And I love you all. Have a great Saturday. Bye.